He's fiery, he fires at will, and he could get fired any day. That's right, I am talking about Donald J. Trump. Donald J. Trump is the 45th president of United States of America.
We will bring back our jobs. We will bring back our borders. We will bring back our wealth. And we will bring back our dreams. From this day forward, it's going to be only America first.
The big question is he also the first paradox? A head of state with a serious debate on the state of his head. And where that has got America and the world headed. After all, nobody in US history has misruled, misinformed, or misled with greater fatality. Yet, nobody in the US history has ruled, informed, and led with greater finality. Trump has divided America in two distinct eras, BD and AD, before Donald and after Donald. So what has changed? Apparently, a lot. The man has used his instincts of provoking, disheveling, and dividing to redefine what it means to be presidential.
He tried to outthink me, and nobody outthinks me. Nobody. Nobody.
Treating the privilege as his personal primetime show. Tell him to clean up the act and he'll tell you that's exactly what he's doing. Cleaning up a global mess.
To be honest, I inherited a mess. It's a mess. It's a mess. At home and abroad. A mess. I turn on the TV, open the newspapers, and I see stories of chaos. Chaos. Chaos.
Tell him he's taking advantage of the world, and he'll tell you that's because the world is taking advantage of America.
But we can't continuously have other nations taking advantage of the United States like never before.
Tell him his technique is drastic, and he'll tell you, yes, but so are the challenges. And that's probably where the clues to the Donald puzzle lie. Is this president unique simply because he is the product of a unique time in history? Is this president different simply because his ruffle and rule style doesn't fit the textbook? Is the world judging Donald Trump on parameters he doesn't control, such as his mannerisms and methods?
A nation without borders is not a nation. Beginning today, the United States of America gets back control of its borders, gets back its borders.
And grudging him some of the credit that's perhaps his due.
When Donald Trump says, "Let's make America great again," that is code for let's take America backward.
One of the challenges for us is to cover him not only as the president of the United States, but as a president who publicly says things that are false, and a president who also is still in business.
After all, what makes Trump a potent disaster is also what makes him an instrument of potential breakthrough. His grab and shake manner means that he is not trapped by conformity. His dislike for manuals means he is not afraid to experiment. His disdain for principles means he is open to suggestions. Instigator of anarchy or instrument of evolution. It probably depends on which side of the fence you want to witness the action from.
I'll tell you what, if I ever got impeached, I think the market would crash. I think everybody would be very poor.
Sure, eyebrows rise when Donald insists that markets will crash and the US will become poor if he is impeached. But doesn't the same show of conviction unite those tired of spineless diplomacy? Sure, Donald's disdain for tradition, such as adding his very own touch of blue to the national flag, raises eyebrows across institutions. But doesn't the same lack of faith in convention unite those who hope for fresh new answers to naughty old problems? Ladies and gentlemen, let the vote begin. Should the United States of America impeach Captain Chaos, or can it dream of becoming great again under its commando of change? It's time for some decoding. Should United States of America pull the plug on America's most unpresidential president, or let him ride unplugged? It's time for answers, ladies and gentlemen, in a voice that's most familiar to you, yours.